Okay. Much more an answer to question mark that sound conclusion. As highlighted by some previous talk, what is this? Okay. Time and mode of island colonization and factor driving the evolution of a vertebrate on an island is one of the most debated intriguing issues in biology, ecology, biogeography, and paleontology as well. This because actually the process depends on the synergistic action of several abiotic, physical, and biotic factor that on the one hand regulated, for instance, the filtering power of the barrier, the nature and the number of niches available on the island, and on the other, the competition of evolutionary dynamics of insular settler. In my personal opinion, to try to understand the problem is necessary to compare the evolutionary trajectories of species that originated from the same ancestor but colonized islands with different surface area in different geographical contexts and maybe at a different time. I chosen to speak about the proboscideans. Why? Because the frequency with which elephant and proboscideans in general colonized the island over the world and giving rise to several endemic taxa differing in size and ecological behavior sometimes, even on a single island. And because among elephants we have the most advanced reduction in size. And another interesting point, my point of view, is the presence of some apomorphies in elephants that originated in different lineages. I'm speaking about stegodont, mammutus, paleoloxeron, that suggests some homoplasy in the group. The body size variation among species is, among island species of course, is in general consistent with the island, as you can see looking at the result of our analysis on extant and fossil species. But the relationship body size in island, body size of male ancestor, the slope is much more steeper in, steeper in fossil, especially in elephant, than in extant species. What about causal factor? Using the regression tree analysis that enables us to compare all the possible causal factors, our result suggests that as regards large mammals, the presence of a competitor is one of the most influencing factors. And my question is this also true as regards to Elephantini? To discuss about this problem, I would like to show you some examples coming from my own research on Elephantini from a Mediterranean island, in particular on fauna that derived from several migration events. For instance, comparing the structure of fauna in Palaeoloxon and Falconeris faunal complex from Sicily, you can see that the size of Palaeoloxon and Falconeri shift toward the size of male and mixed feeder deer that were absent on the island. The niche of large moss mammals like leporid became probably available for the giant Sicilian breed, while Crocidura size shift toward the size of erinaceus. Looking at the structure of fauna from Palaeoloxon mariensis faunal complex, I want to highlight that this area, the surface area of the island, was more or less the same, and also the productivity, at least according to the vegetation record. The situation is completely different. Elephant and large size herbivore only slightly reduce the size, the sort of scaling, according to the shift to niche inside the same trophic group, while large medium-sized carnivore don't show any significant change in body size. That is consistent with the only slight change in size of the preferred one. Looking at the other size of the Mediterranean, on Crete, the oldest Crete misofaunal complex show more or less the same pattern that the Sicilian Palaeoloxon falconeri fauna. As does the most recent Mus minotaurus faunal complex. This in spite of the fact that on Crete predator were not present, and the competitor were there different in size and ecological behavior. A hypothesis to be validated. I don't know if it's correct or not. The change in body size of insular elephants is a predictable response to the change in the competition dynamic and niche availability on the new insular habitat. Niche that generally are unattainable for elephant on mainland. If the hypothesis is correct, we can assume that given the intrinsic characteristic connected with their bioplan, removing biotic and abiotic environmental constraints, the body size of insular species may shift toward the size, allowing the best energetic balance when the competition and the predator pressure decreases and the resource availability changes, probably decreasing also. This is roughly supported by the shift in size of insular Mediterranean mammal compared with the structure that I have obtained. I'm not able to. Okay. For the fauna during the Middle Pleistocene in all the Mediterranean area. Just a working hypothesis, a real simple conceptual model. We can suppose that in an ideal continental community, niche scales in a predictable way. but just a few species can cross the barrier and reach the island. As a result, in the insular ecosystem, the niche occupied on mainland by the species that are absent on the focal island become free for the colonizer, and the reduced competition pressure allows insular group carnivore species to optimize energetic balance, the quality of life, and the shift toward the best size fitting with the species above plan. Is that true? If so, taking into account this 4 points, we may assume that reducing the body size and increasing the metabolic rate, elephants may have a higher reproductive rate, the population size may grow rapidly, avoiding the threat of extinction, and reducing their size, all large herbivores can increase the possibility of optimized energy cost, and exploiting environmental opportunity may be reducing their own range. However, the relationship among body mass, life history, metabolic rate is an extremely complex phenomenon, difficult to understand in living, and especially in fossil mammals, of course. And looking at elephants, since heterochrony sometimes result in pedomorphosis, pedomorphosis could be expected. Actually, in elephant, the species with the smallest size, Falconeri, Tiriensis, Oxylophagus, show marked pedomorphic feature in the skull. But it's not the same for limb bones, even if being elephant, the individuals that have an exaggerated proportion in limb bones, pedomorphic traits may be expected in elephant. Moreover, looking at the comparison among young elephant from Spinagallo cave, the smallest we know, adult from the same cave, a young elephant, extant elephant, Loxodonta elephas maximus, you can see that there are no real structural similarity, and that in adult young elephant from Spinagallo cave, the center of mass is placed more or less in the same position that in adult extant elephant, while in the adult the body mass shift according to the much elongated skeleton, the position of the pelvis and other peculiarities. So the difference in proportion from young adult elephant from Spinagallo cave are more related to static factor than to reduction in size. Another point, body size reduction means faster life. Analyzing long bones from Spinagallo cave is a project together with Michael Kuhler. We have noted that the growth is slower than in extant elephant, and the age of sexual maturity is only slightly younger than the age in extant elephant. So apparently no faster life. But another intriguing point, analyzing all the skull of two male from Spinagallo Cave, I have noted that tasklessness is absolutely present in all the specimens, and probably it is a genetic process, because you can see the difference between, okay, on the left, a young male with the protruding milk tusk. In the middle, a young female with the milk tusk inside the alveolus that is ossified at the distal part. In the adult female, the alveolus is completely ossified. So, what do we know? We know that the most influencing factor as regard to the body size reduction is probably ecological release, ecological interaction, presence of competitor in the same guild. That geographical isolation and time of isolation, as well as island physiography and the variety of environmental possibility is some other factor that directly, I think indirectly, may affect the size reduction. The body size probably change for a more efficient use of energy, and the other thing we can note that the more marked the reduction in size is, the more evident allometric variation and pedomorphic feature in skull are. What we don't know, what we have scrutinized about, the relationship between the body size and ontogenetic growth, the relationship between anagenetic evolution on island and adaptive radiation, when there are more than one species and we don't know the exact chronology of specimen. We have to disentangle among size-related, size-required, ecological constraining features to confirm or reject the hypothesis that some pedomorphic traits are present in limb bones, and also the significance of some departure from the hypothesis. And thinking about, for instance, the quite large size of Palaeoloxodon tiliensis that inhabited a small island with very low results, had no competitor, as it is definitely larger than Palaeoloxodon from Parker group. What we have to do first, to remove, for instance, this question mark implicit in a hypothetical phylogenetic reconstruction. We have to provide a robust chronology assessment for all the specimens we know. And also to clarify whether the species complex, I have here mainly the Palaeoloxodon X group, may be referred to a sort of syngamon or not. Okay, maybe a completely different truth exists. And I thank you for your attention.